All right, hello and welcome back to Jump One Half. So, I haven't uploaded a lot recently, and part of the reason why is because I've been so busy at work. I've just been too tired to want to edit videos and whatnot. But one of my favorite YouTubers, Cubic Tom, has started putting out videos of this game, so I thought, I really want to be able to keep up with his videos as he goes along. So, I'm going to try to at least maintain a consistent upload schedule for a little while, and hopefully until the end of the game, really, so that I don't have to wait to watch his videos. It's just... wow, that was certainly an interaction. So I'm back at this level because I now finally have that yellow switch that I needed to be able to access the secret exit. I'm pretty sure it's possible to make it to the secret exit without the yellow switch. Like, I'm pretty sure you could throw... whoops. Well, I guess I may as well grab it. I'm pretty sure you could bring a second shell over here, throw one of these guys up in the air as he's waking up, land on him, and then catch the other shell and do a shell jump off the left wall, or maybe even the pipe. But it looks like you'll hit the block if you do that. I think it's easier off the left wall. I'm pretty sure that's possible, but this is so much easier. There might even be an easier way to do it, I don't know. But anyways, that was hot kicking, so piece of cake since it's a world level, one level again. This group of trees is cold. Good to know. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. By frozen quills. I suppose that is fitting. Also, I see that old is capitalized, so not sure if old is the operative word here instead of cold, but well, cold definitely is. So that pipe, not sure what that is. Maybe there's a one-up thing that spawns a block, like, right there. One of those one-up checkpoint things. Alright, that worked out well. I feel like there might be something up there, so let's check it out. I really feel like there's something I'm missing in this level already. Like, what are those blue blocks for? They don't look like a help. In fact, they seem like much of a hindrance because they'll make those guys jump a whole bunch. It also feels like some of these pathways are also irrelevant right now, but I don't know. Maybe it's something I'll figure out, or maybe I'm just overthinking things. Just do that. Now I can't throw fireballs, but that's okay. Okay, now I gotta time this one. And not hit my head like a dummy. Yeah, I made it. Nice. Is this a one-up? Cool. I was thinking it was a... oh, no. Well, this isn't much better. Thankfully, that actually worked out pretty well. I was able to walk because I was standing on a sprite block. So even though I was standing in a one-high area, I was able to just walk forward. Which honestly wasn't an interaction I knew about, but whoa, I should stop talking. But it ended up coming through for me regardless, so. Alright. Just jump over this guy. Whoops. Well, that didn't work out well at all. That said, though, I think a lot of these obstacles definitely get easier if you're small, so hopefully that should work to my favor, even though it's technically not as good as being big. Okay. Yeah, it's kind of hard to get around these sprite blocks, because their hitbox is just a little bit larger than a normal block. So all I need to do here is run across. I don't need to do any cool sliding tricks. Alright. Assuming I can't jump over that. I don't think that would make it past playtesting and jump one half. It's a little bit too solidly built. Oh hey, a mushroom. Alright, so I don't think I can really use that platform well. Nope. Well, I lost it immediately. I haven't been any dragon coins though, so I just think I need to make it to the end. Whoops. That timing of that platform is bad. I think it'll be good here. Ugh, but I messed it up. Yeah. Do that time instead of just being a huge dummy. Ugh, not good, not good enough. Okay, this should be good. There we go, jumped off it fast enough. Okay, so I guess I gotta bounce on those guys and make it over to the brown blocks. Well, that didn't work out super well because they were breathing fire, but it was good enough to continue, so I'll take that. Oh hey, looks like I can stomp my way down there since I'm big. Or not? That's what I thought that was for. There we go. Now let's see what's in that block. Okay. There we go. Oh, I guess it's just a vine to make it to the 50 points. Well, I'll take it. I got 40 at least. That's enough for another life, which is good because my life counter is starting to go down a bit. Alright, well, it's starting to look like this particular path right here is going to be a Get the Switch Palaces path, because I need the yellow one to get to here, and I'll need the blue one to continue onwards. And this gives me a shortcut back to where I was before, so yeah, it's seeming like I'll need to get the blue one, and then presumably the red, and then maybe the green at the end. Botanical plant. I did not check who made that. That was stupid. It's so hard to remember. Okay. So, I'm assuming this guy can't hurt you. Yeah, okay. He's only a help. May as well kill a few of these guys since somebody's so freely dispensing these blocks over here. And we gotta use it to break that. Okay, that gets rid of the block. The pipe does. Well, it's easy if I just wait over there. I don't think there's any use to going up there. And no use to bringing a block over here. Alright. Okay, they only shot once, which was good. Because avoiding a second one there might have been tricky. Oh, they shoot more than just nice friendly blocks. I mean, I still kind of needed those, so it was still kind of friendly, but not quite as friendly. Okay, good thing the ascending glitch has been fixed, so this becomes pretty safe, even though it feels really dangerous. And that definitely feels dangerous. Oh, whoops. I forgot those were platforms that enemies could go through, but you couldn't. So I was trying to bounce on the magic. Okay, let's duck before going on the vine. Okay, that guy releases the saw, whatever. Oh, shoot. Didn't expect him to come back there. Whoa, that guy just releases all the saws. Alright, goodbye to those guys. Okay, I gotta bounce on him here. Bouncing on saws isn't too bad unless you have to bounce really low, because if you have to bounce really low, it's really hard to react in time. That's what a lot of Kaizo levels do. Timing was not good there. I don't see any good timing here. Nah, I really shouldn't have gone. I should have just been patient. Well, let's get myself the spring. I don't need this block, but if you're gonna give it to me, then fine, I'll take your present. Won't look a gift block in the whoa, platforms, that's interesting. I didn't go up there because I thought maybe there was something on the other side that I would have liked, but... Okay, so they act like potabos, those platforms, but instead of being actual potabos, you can just stand on them. Ugh. It's not timing that very well. Yeah, that definitely messes with my head. I want to jump on the one that's there, not the next one, even though the next one is the one you want to jump on. Okay, I guess I want to be on the right side and just jump up. No problem. Okay. A little bit of momentum makes that easier, but I didn't have a lot. Whoops. Alright, give me that mushroom, because I don't want to die here. I've made it through quite a fair amount since the last checkpoint, so... Oh, okay, I actually need a block still. Did that guy respawn? Doesn't look like it. So I'm safe to go back and get the block. Alright, so this time let's be a little bit faster. Okay, we had a good opening. Just jump up there. Don't need the block anymore. That lined itself up very nicely, but I still messed it up anyway. I think if he shot that one to the left there, I would have gotten killed, so I'm glad he didn't do that. And now it looks like some sort of boss. What on earth will this be? Oh, it's plants. Oh, it's also you. He's kind of standing in the wrong spot. Well, I've gotten hit both the other times, let's try not to repeat that. Standing in the center, probably not the best idea for that boss fight, because when you want to jump, there are fireballs there. So if she appears in the center, one of the dummies appears in the center, you're just gonna get hit. But yeah, really fun level. Almost forgot it was a castle by the end of it, but Wendy was a skillful gardener, but Mario wasn't to be ensnared with flowers. Not so that such was that happy garden state while there's still a princess to rescue. Oh, I never realized how hard it was to read this font out loud with the large gaps in between the words. No saving. This level was by Snorant Pyro. Always a good level designer. Misty Mountain Pass. By Witherskelly. Made a lot of levels towards the start of this. And we actually have dragon coins this time, so I'd better be on the lookout for those. The mountain air is filling you with determination and the ability to double jump? This will only work if you jump from solid ground. Okay. But it looks like running off is actually fine. I guess they're ruling out the jumping out of water. Probably so that they can use water to save you in places like this. Yeah, I thought that would be a roof. It didn't make sense to do anything else. Alright. Go! gotta love the random excuse for being able to double jump. The mountain air is filling you with determination. It's just kind of amusing. Oh hey, a star. What on earth do I use this for? Well, I should probably go the other way instead of running straight into a wall with it. Is there something specific that I need this for, or... Oh! Man, I just got to that in time. So it's a star run, I've got to get to the next one too. But there's also dragon coins scattered about. Oh shoot. Oh yeah, I can double jump because... do I wait for this? I don't want to lose my star. Well, I don't know what the star is useful for yet. Maybe it gets me a moon later. Maybe I need it for a dragon coin. I don't know. But I can't, it's really hard to get the star to the end and grab the dragon coins at the same time, so... Especially blind. Like, I'm sure it would not be that difficult if you already knew the exact layout of the level, but... it's really hard to move super fast if you've never been through a level before. Dang it. Wasted my double jump, more or less. Oh, well, it doesn't matter. I have to deal with the, evil green floating platform now. Big deal. It's so common that I look at a gap and think, wait, I really shouldn't have killed that guy because now I can't get over there. And it's like, oh yeah, right, I can jump twice. It's just, I'm so hardwired to know what gaps I can jump on based on the height. So something like this just kind of throws me off my game. In a good way, of course. I mean, obviously if it's going to benefit you. I can't double spin jump. Well, I can. I just need to press the B button the second time. Oh, wow. I just really plunked myself in the face there. Just before I really would have wanted a cape. Nope, no, nothing there. Whoops. I was standing just a little bit away from the bullet blaster. Didn't think I was. Dang rocks down here. Get off my lawn, rocks. Also time. Alright, better gotta go fast. Gotta be Sonic the Hedgehog here. Okay, bouncing on enemies does not refresh the double jump. Hey, I got a lot of coins. That was close. Also, I'm missing a dragon coin. Now, where could that be? Maybe it's just down a pipe I didn't check? Yes, there is. Okay, this is what I missed. Wow, if I could just grab the P-switch, thanks. Okay. Okay, I can see ahead. But what's the point? What exactly is this room? If I wait for the P-switch to go back, the next jump is really easy. But... Oh, okay. Okay, so now this is a race, and I messed it up. Well, I'm going down the hole, see ya. Oh, well, dang. I was trying to go up the left side because I thought you had to bonk it and get through, but I didn't realize that, oh, you could just go up the right side instead. Ah, dang it. Okay, yeah, that was probably easier than doing things the traditional way. Oh, and this is for a moon. But that still begs the question of where the last dragon coin is then. Oh hey, I can see the dragon coin from here. I don't know how to get to it, but I can see it. Alright, yeah, it's just through here. Dang, that was actually kind of hard to find. Yeah, that was a super fun level. Cool gimmick, lots of alternate pathways and cool secrets to find. It wasn't exactly a romp, but it was kind of romp flavored, if that makes any sense. Color a Dinosaur by Asositration. Apparently there's a movie of this level or in this level. Not sure what this is about. Alright. So I see my dinosaur. This mysterious place you can change Yoshi's color. Simply drop him in the hole below, then take the pipe to claim your Yoshi again. Dang it, I want to hit the other one. Yoshi's color is determined by the combination of magics you input. You may also receive a power-up if it's the right combination. I'm not 100% sure I get it, but it's green. Well, exciting, I have a whole green Yoshi. Not sure where I could have possibly found another one. Ow! It hit me! I can die here? I mean, besides jumping down the hole myself, obviously. Oh, I guess that's the price I have to pay for a blue Yoshi. Well, not that it means anything, because I'm not going to use the blue Yoshi to cheese anything, which means it's basically just a green Yoshi, but whatever. Danger Town. Ooh. Getting dangerous up in here. Mandu and Lol Yoshi. So is it Danger Town USA, or is it Danger Town, like, Luxembourg or something? Oh, boy, it's scrolling. Were there Yoshi coins? I don't know if I have to be on the guard, on the lookout for those. Gotta get my phrases right and stop mixing them. Stay on guard, or stay on the lookout. When some of the saws are upside down and some of them aren't, I almost always screw it up, for one reason or another. Hey, it's a vine. Does this take me to anything cool? Sure does. Is this 2 1-ups? Sheesh, my life counter is going back up again. I was at 25 lives at the start of this episode, and until this episode, I'd been slowly declining for quite a while, and then now, it's like, wow, I'm back at 38 lives again. Can I go up here? No, it's not that nice. Wow, that was... that disco shell tracked me very well. I just could not get out from under him. If I still had my cape, I could possibly get some more 1-ups here. Well, I'm a bit too... oh, I could have gotten the midpoint. Well, I guess I should just not die then. That would be the preferable thing to do, not dying. Oh boy. Okay, timed itself well there. It wouldn't have if I didn't have the cape. Notably enough. Okay, there's platforms down here. But thanks to the cape, I have lots of time to react. And now no more cape. That's sad. Whoa, there's another one. That sucked. Why would I want to hit that? Oh, I guess to get that. Well, that kind of defeated the purpose. Definitely want to go over those. That was very close. I only barely made it to that platform. Man, that was pretty tense. But I don't dislike tense in Mario levels. I mean, I don't usually, but... see, that blue Yoshi's coming in handy already. Looking cool on the overworld and nothing else. Wait, who made this last level? Oh yeah, Mandu and Lol Yoshi. Yeah, very good combination, apparently. Brothers in Arms by just Lol Yoshi this time. Man. I think I've got time. Let's do it. It's only yellow exit. If it was red exit, I wouldn't. I don't know, are you supposed to be my brother? Oh, it's probably Hammer Bros then. I was like, I don't know if I'm supposed to kill this random Goomba here. Maybe I should just leave this one guy alone. Yoink. Om nom nom nom. Don't remember if you can eat boomerangs. It probably varies game to game. Hold Yoshi's tongue out upwards to get that guy. If I was not on Yoshi, I could have used him to kill the Hammer Bro. That actually would have been a little bit easier. Welp. May as well jump back to safety. I feel like there's something in here. Well, may as well go in there first then. Oh, okay. Looks like these are little Hammer Bro fight rooms. Oh no, it's just one... It's just one room. Okay. So, I can dispose of Yoshi here. Is there anything better I can do? Probably not. Nope. Bye, Yoshi. Ironically, it was to get a Yoshi coin. Dang it, I was hoping that other boomerang would come back. Buy mushroom. Losing all the stuff. Oh man, how do I get this one? That seems like a really tight jump to make. If you're just supposed to make it. The boomerangs do not go the right height, so which implies that I need to take a boomerang from somewhere else. Or jump off Yoshi again. I mean, I can just go to the end of the level and then do that. Oh, but I should jump off Yoshi and get that one first, so that I can make my cheese complete. Alright, I just skipped those guys by going through the pipe, so... No reason to go back and- whoa, do that again. Jumping on Hammer Bros is definitely not as scary in this game as it is in others, but it's still somewhat scary. Because they really like to throw a hammer right in your face right as you do it. Let's see if I can at least get it out with the 3 Dragon Coins I have currently. Oh, I made it to the midpoint, which is as good as out. Point of advice, like most things in Super Mario World, you can spin jump safely on the boomerangs. Yes, I was aware. But if I can be lazy and just murder Yoshi several times to get all the dragon coins, may as well do that too. Well, shell jumping works better if you don't have a fire flower and don't do that. Help, okay, I'm just gonna go. See ya. Dang it, that was stupid. Just barely got that with the iframes. Alright, you get back up to the top so that I can make it to wherever I need to go, which would have been easy regardless, but whatever. Oh wow, we're running out of time. Better not panic or anything. Dang it. That wasn't really panic, it was just I couldn't really see what I- Oh, shoot, that was going the other way. Well, that's unfortunate. So hitting them both is Blue Yoshi. I'm assuming that's how it works. Oh hey! I get a cape for that too. And Yellow Yoshi. I suppose cape would go well with yellow, but I didn't get a fire flower- Well, I got a fire flower with a Yoshi that wasn't red, so that doesn't necessarily make sense to me. Well, I'm gonna go back. There, gotcha. Because I'm pretty sure I can just go back to that pipe, right? Or was it again? I don't even remember. Aha, it was just past here. It's just as easy to get it from the midpoint as it is to get it from the start, so may as well do it now and see if I can save myself a trip back to this level later. Alright. So, I'm just gonna try to break the gimmick, so don't need to worry about you. I can eat you. me actually just get this with the cape, I think. There we go. Goodbye. I feel kind of mean for cheesing this, but I normally try to avoid cheesing things by flying. I always try to avoid that. Unless I actually think that's supposed to be the solution to a puzzle, I don't do it. But if I can cheese something just by floating, eh. Or by jumping off of Yoshi, I'll just do it. If I have the means to do it. Which I definitely did in this case, because we've got Color of Dinosaur sitting right there. Honestly, you almost would have thought this would have been a no Yoshi zone. Because he certainly breaks a lot of this now that I think about it. The cape certainly isn't making this any less cheesy either. Alright, let's take the cape back because it's just been so helpful in this level. Can I fly over that? Well, I can't if I don't even get that high. Whoops, there goes my Yoshi. Oh, bridges are solid still. Oh, wow! That was a pro jump, guy. I'll give you mad props for that. Well, at least I get to experience the parts of the levels I didn't play as they were actually intended to be played. Ugh. Their timing was completely in sync, which I didn't really understand how I was supposed to get up there. Dang it, that did not work at all. Somehow double eat him. The cape completely breaks this jump. Let's just wait for the Pokey to die. No need to rush things. Yeah, getting rid of the Lava Lotus makes this obstacle pretty easy until I mess it up anyways. Just bouncing the boomerang. Oh, can't do that. I guess you were supposed to bounce on the other guy's boomerangs to get the goal 50, but whatever. Wow, gained 15 lives this episode. It's a little bit better than usual, especially for recently. And I think that'll be the ending here. Jermaine Confusion. Why do I feel like this is made by Yulp? Okay, Yulp and a Terraformer. Okay, that makes doubly much sense. Well, anyways, that's it for now. See you next time!